Hey everyone, it's me, Ian. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a quick digital art speed paint of some fan art from the anime show The Great Pretender, which has a lot to offer for people who like anime and for people who don't. I think that this is one of the best animes to try and get somebody into who doesn't previously like anime. A lot of people have like hang-ups about anime. I kind of do too, even though I've been watching a lot of it lately. You know, it has this reputation for being kind of weird. You know, it's got a lot of supernatural, paranormal stuff in it. And then there's also like the cultural differences between like Americans and Japanese people. So a lot of times I think Americans are resistant to watch anime because they don't understand Japanese honorifics. They don't understand differences with the school life, you know, after school clubs, or even the way that class structures are, you know, the family dynamics in Japanese homes. It just feels too unrelatable, I guess, for American audiences, or at least that's what I assume. I know for me, if there's an anime I don't have interest in watching, it's probably because of maybe sense of humor differences, or maybe just like the attraction of like weird pervy guys in the anime, like, you know, that kind of thing is treated like a joke in anime. It makes me uncomfortable a lot of times, honestly. But all that to say, honestly, I don't think you should write off anime as a genre necessarily, because there is a lot of anime out there that is not alienating for a Western audience and maybe can help broaden your horizons. I think that The Great Pretender is one of those shows. It has a lot of things going for it that I think would interest a person who doesn't typically watch anime. First and foremost, this anime doesn't really even take place in Japan. Only the first part of like the first episode takes place in Japan. The rest of it takes place in various countries. And as a result, a lot of the cast of the show, the cast of characters are not Japanese. So you've got a Frenchman, you've got this girl who was born in the Middle East. And of course you've got a Japanese main character, and because you've got these various different ethnicities represented, they don't tap into a lot of those typical like Japanese cultural influences that you typically find in anime. So there's not a lot of use of like honorifics or anything like that, especially obviously in the English dub, which I think was really good. This show was produced by Netflix, so I feel like maybe that's part of the reason why it has such an appeal to an American audience. But what the show's actually about is like these con men or confidence men who run very like sophisticated scams, basically, and they have this kind of honor system where they only con other criminals, and so you feel comfortable rooting for them. I think that this show has the vibe of like an Ocean's movie, and they run these very complicated games almost. Their jobs. And the thing that I think that makes this show interesting is that these characters who are as part of this group together, Team Confidence as it's sometimes called, they're really not necessarily friends with each other per se. They're not family, and they make this clear in this show. They have this sort of quote-unquote rule that everybody looks out for themselves. Honestly, they do take care of each other and look after each other, but part of their whole philosophy is if they think that they can make the scam run better, or if they've got an idea, they'll just start doing it without consulting the other members, and this leads to a lot of chaos, obviously. So I think that the show is really cool for that regard. There's kind of elements of mystery in it because you don't always know what the other characters are thinking if you're following one character's perspective. And I just think that it's a really cool, upbeat, energetic show. The art style of the show is amazing, with like super bright colors, like super harsh angles. It's just really unique looking. And I tried to capture a little bit of that in this fan art, the vibrancy of the show. And it really, I think, complements the themes of the show. It has that vibrant kind of feel to it. And it's very lively and energetic. So, I highly recommend watching The Great Pretender. Thanks for watching this video, and have a good one. Bye!